This self-learning video is created by Jagrat Creations. This video is on consignment accounts. This video may be useful to the students who are reading for CA Foundation, ICWAI Foundation, FYBcom, 12th Commerce, CA-CPT, because this video is on consignment accounts. I want to solve one sum on consignment accounts. Observe the sum on the screen. Adapted from CA 2003. Vanita traders of Delhi purchased 10,000 pieces of saris at the rate of rupees 100 per sari. So 10,000 pieces are purchased. Out of these saris, 6,000 saris were sent on consignment to Kaivanya of Nagpur at a selling price of 120 per sari. So out of this 10,000 units, 6,000 units are sent to the consignee for selling at a commission. Consignor paid 3,000 for packing and freight. Kaivanya sold 5,000 saris at 125 per sari, incurred rupees 1,000 for selling expenses and remittance of 5 lakh to Delhi on account. So 6,000 saris are sent to the consignee. Kaivanya sold 5,000 saris. So 1,000 is a consignment stock. They are entitled to a commission of 5% on total sales, plus further 20% of the commission on surplus price realized over 120 per sari. This is the commission calculation. 3,000 saris were sold at 110 per sari. Now see, 10,000 pieces were purchased, 6,000 sent to the consignee. Consignee has sold 5,000 units. 1,000 is the consignment stock. Out of 10,000, 6,000 sent to the consignee. 4,000 is held by the consignor. Out of this 4,000, 3,000 saris were sold at 110. So 4,000 minus 3,000, that is the stock held by the consignor. Owing to the fall in market price, the value of stock of saris on hand is to be reduced by 10%. Prepare consignment account, trading account in the books of Vanita traders and there are accounts in the books of agents, Mrs. Kevin and of Naipur. These are the various accounts to be prepared. It's okay. Now let me start with the sum. This is the details of the sum. Number of accounts that I prepare notice. Consignment account, trading account, consignee account, goods sent on consignment account and profit and loss account. These are the various accounts I prepare for your better understanding. First transaction, 10,000. Pieces of saris at rupees 100. 10,000 into 100. Purchases are 10 lakhs. So goods purchased 10 lakhs. Normal entry is what? Purchase account debit to bank or creditor account credit. But all the purchases are debited to the trading account at the end of the year. So I am going to debit these purchases to the debit side of trading account. The adjustment entry for that is trading account debit to purchases account credit. 10 lakhs. Out of that, 6,000 saris were sent on consignment for sale by consignment. So 6,000 units are sent. Out of this 10,000, 6,000 units are sent. So trading account is to be credited for goods outward, and goods sent on consignment account is to be debited. So 6,000 saris, its cost is 6,000 into 100. So cost of goods sent is 6 lakhs. Goods sent on consignment account debit to trading account credit. So out of this 10,000, 6,000 are goods sent on consignment. Now, at the selling price of 120, when the goods are sent to the consignee or for consignment activity, the goods are sent at an invoice price. So what is the invoice price? 6,000 into 120 is the invoice price, 720,000. So consignment account is to be debited with the invoice price. So consignment account debit to goods sent on consignment account credit, and the profit load therein will be credited to consignment account. So consignment account debit to goods sent on consignment account credit, 720,000, and this profit load, goods sent on consignment account debit to consignment account credit, this is the adjustment entry. So 720,000 minus 120,000, 6 lakhs. 720,000 minus 120,000, 6 lakhs. So 6 lakhs, 6 lakhs adjusted, and here the cost of goods and gets debited. This is how it gets recorded in goods and on consignment account, trading account and consignment account. Here it's recorded at an invoice price. Profit load in invoice price is adjusted by recording entry on the credit side. Here the goods end at recorded at an invoice price. The profit load adjusted by debiting the amount 120,000. This is how the account gets prepared. When the goods are sent at an invoice price and trading account is to be credited at cost for the goods sent on consignment account. The consignor paid rupees, this account gets closed. The consignor paid rupees 3000, consignment account debit to cash account. This 3000 will be added here to find out the cost of goods in transit. This is the invoice price of goods in transit. So, expenses incurred is done. Kaivanya sold 5000 saris at 125 per sari. Now 5000 into 125. Goods are sold, consignment account is to be credited, consignee account is to be debited. What is the value? 5000 into 125, 625,000. Consignee account debit to consignment account credit. This is the sales that I have recorded. The goods are sold, goods of my ownership are sold by consignee. Consignee is the receiver of my funds, so consignee is a receiver. So consignee account is to be debited. And consignment account is to be credited. Consignment account is a functional account and its function is to find out the profit by consignment activity. So all the goods sent and the expenses incurred for this consignment activity gets debited. Sales proceeds and stock gets credited to consignment account, and by that we find out the profit on consignment activity by matching concept. Now 5000 units are sold, 1000 selling expenses, consignment account debit to consignee account credit, because consignee is the giver of this payment which I should have done. So consignee is the giver, it's an expense of my consignment activity, consignment account debit to consignee account credit. Now remittance of 5000, I have received 5 lakhs from the consignee, cash or bank account debit to consignee account credit, consignee is the giver, credit the giver, consignee account is to be credited. Now next, this is the consignment stock. They are entitled to a commission of 5% on total sales, plus further 120%, further 20% commission on any surplus price realized over 120. Now see, here I am required to calculate the commission. Now see, commission is to be calculated. How? They are entitled to a commission of 5% on total sales. Total sales is 625,000. So 5% of 625,000, 31,250 is the commission at the rate of 5%. Further 20% commission on the surplus price realized over 120. Here, the sales has occurred at the rate of 125 and surplus realized over 120 is 5 rupees. So 5 rupees is the surplus per unit realized. How many units are sold? 5,000 units are sold. So 5,000 into 5. 25,000. This is a surplus that has been realized. See, 125 into 120, 5 rupees surplus. On how many units? 5,000 units. So 5,000 into 5, 25,000. 25,000 into 20%. That works out to be 5,000. So this is the additional commission to be paid. Total commission to be paid, 36,250. This is how it has been worked out. Now this commission to be paid is an expense of consignment activity. So consignment account debit to consignee account credit. This is how the commission got recorded. Now commission is done. Now next point that I want to consider is consignment stock. Out of 6,000, 5,000 are sold, 1,000 is the consignment stock. Let me work out the consignment stock. There is a reduction of 10% thereon. So I will go for reduction afterwards. But let me first work out the consignment stock. 6,000 units cost is 6,3,000. How much for 1,000 units? So if you work out 6,3,000 into 1,000 divided by 6,000, you will get this number cost. Now I want to find out the invoice price thereof. How to find out the invoice price? 6,000 units invoice price is 7,23,000. How much for 1,000 units? That works out to be 1,20,000. Let me write out this cost and invoice price, which is to be deducted by 10% later on. So I just write down the consignment stock in this fashion. After calculating this consignment stock, the next point that I want to consider is 3,000 saris were sold by the consignor himself. He has purchased 10,000 saris. He has given 6,000 saris for consignment activity. 3,000 saris are sold at 110. That's a sales that I credit to the trading account. So 3,30,000 is a sales that has occurred at Delhi. This is the consignor's sale. Now, owing to the fall in market price, the value of stock in hand 10% less. So this stock is to be reduced by 10%. So 10% of 1,500,000 is 10,050. This is the 10% of 1,20,500. So this is the consignment stock. I write this consignment stock for the credit side of consignment account at an invoice price. And the difference between the two, 1,08,450 minus 90,450, difference is 18,000, that I am going to write a stock reserve to the debit side of consignment account. So this is how consignment stock is recorded at invoice price and the stock reserve is debited. Now here 10,000 minus 6,000 minus 3,000, 9,000 are to be deducted from 10,000. 1,000 units are in stock. Its cost is at the rate of 100, so 1 lakh. There is a 10% reduction in the value. See, purchase price was 100 rupees per sari, and here he has purchased 10,000 saris. 6,000 are sent on consignment, 3,000 are sold. 10,000 minus 6,000 minus 3,000, 1,000 units is the stock on hand. Its cost is 100, so 1 lakh minus 10% decrease. So 90,000 is the realizable value. Cost or net realizable value is the mode of valuation. So this trading account will be credited with 90,000. This is how the closing stock at Delhi is calculated. Now there is an alternative way to report this consignment stock. Instead of writing consignment stock in this fashion, there is an optional way of writing the consignment stock wherein proposed expenses will be ignored, that I will demonstrate in the next sum that I am going to consider after this sum. So after this video, if you refer to the next sum, you will understand the alternative way of making valuation of consignment stock wherein proportional expenses will not be considered. But here in this sum, I haven't done that. So here the consignment stock at Delhi is 90,000. Now I want to find out the profit, etc. This is the total of credit minus total of debit. This is a profit. That profit is transferred to the credit side of profit and loss account, consignment account. Consignor is wrong, consignment account. Here this is the profit to be transferred to profit and loss account. From that, expenses will be deducted and the net profit will be added to capital. This is the consignee account. This is the amount of balance carried forward, 87,750. Here it should not be consignor account, it should be consignment account. It's a mistake. Anyway, this is the closing balance. Now I have tried to explain you this sum, taking every transaction and explaining its journal entry too. I feel that you have followed these things. Thanks to all of you.